स्वरूपिनो याभ्यां विना न पश्यन्ति सिद्धः स्वान्तास्तमीश्वरम् वन्दे बोधमयं नित्यं गुरुशङ्कररूपिणं यमाश्रितो हि वक्रोऽपि चन्द्रः सर्वत्र वन्दते चन्द्रः सर्वत्र वन्द्यते सीताराम गुणग्राम पुण्यरनिव विहारिनो वन्दे विशुद्ध्य विज्ञान कवीश्वर कपीश्वरो कवीश्वर कपीश्वरो श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम बोलो
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
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 सीतावधि रामचंद्र भगवान की। और कथा लास्ट नाइट वाज टेकन फ्रॉम उत्तरकांड ऑफ रामचरितमानस वेयर वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज कॉल्ड सप्त प्रश्न का कथा, दैट इज द सेवन क्वेश्चन कथा, वेयर गरुड़ इज आस्किंग भुजन जी का क्वेश्चन एंड भुजन जी आर हैविंग दिस डिस्कशन. And Garuda is asking Bhushanji to explain to him what are the morals and values of human existence, how you and I should live. And the question that he asks, he says, tell me, what is the most difficult form to obtain in this world? Of all of God's creation, of all the different beings, which is the most difficult one to acquire? And he says, then tell me, what is the greatest pain and what is the highest form of pleasure? He says, then also explain to me the good qualities and bad qualities, and also tell me what is the highest religious merit and what is the most deadly sin. And then further tell me, what is the disease of the mind? What is the disease of the mind? Last night we covered a few of the questions and the answers. He says that the human body is the most difficult to attain, and it is the highest or the one that is closest to relationship to God. And he explained to us that when we have this human form, we must appreciate that we are at a status very close to God. And we are minded that when we come into this world, according to our Vedas, according to our scriptures, that every person that takes birth receives four gifts at the time of birth. Charu Phalme, Dharma, Arth, Kaam or Moksh. That these four gifts are granted to all humanity. Dharma, we have the ability to relate to God and to develop actions, say words and to think thoughts that will bring us close to God. This is called Dharma. Then there is Artha, that we have the ability to acquire and to take from this world whatever brings comfort and adds security to our existence. You know, security, materialistic security, that God, I'm in your world, I have water, I have food, I have clothing, I have shelter, and I'm comfortable in this world, that is Arth. Kaam. Kaam is that we have been granted five senses and five action organs. That, oh Lord, you have given me these five senses, let me apply them in such a way that they bring joy and fulfillment to my life and at the same time contribute to the betterment of all of humankind. And then lastly, there is moksha. The fruit of moksha says that when you have this human body, you're the pinnacle of ultimate binding with God, becoming one with God. And he said it starts from birth. Many of us believe we get moksha when we die. We cannot get moksha when we die if we did not live in a status of moksha while we lived. And if we live in a status of moksha when we die, then we will never return. And that is the ultimate moksha. Thus, Bhushanji is saying to Garud that this human body is the final stage to that journey to becoming one with God. Then he goes on to say that there is no misery in the world There's nothing more miserable in the world to exist in poverty. Daridrata is the word that's used, but when we say poverty, we are thinking of something of a materialistic nature. When we use the word poverty, we relate it to monetary value. I'm echoing. We relate it to monetary value. And as such, this is not what is meant in the scriptures when it talks about poverty. There are two types of wealth in the world. There is what is called the man ka daulat or tan ka daulat. That is the wealth of the mind and the wealth of the body. The wealth of the body is measured by our monetary value, but the wealth of the mind, that is measured by our good qualities. So if we have two types of wealth, that means we have two types of poverty. When we impoverish because we do not have materialistic things, that's one type of poverty. But the poverty that the great saint is talking about is when we are poor in the mind, when we have no love for God. We cannot express compassion, we cannot be forgiving, we cannot be understanding. We do not have a desire to help and to seek into the welfare for the betterment of others. He says, then we are daridrata, we are really poor. And that is the worst state of existence to be. Although we may have everything in the world, and if we are poor in the mind, he says, then we are truly poor in the world itself. Then he goes on to tell us that to be charitable is to be good. To be charitable is to be good. And when we say charitable, it's not to be one who writes a check necessarily, because charity begins at home. So charity is not about giving money. Charity is about giving from the self. And he says that person who is charitable, who is in concern about the welfare of others and is willing to give of themselves for the happiness and the fulfillment of others, he says, that is the highest form of charity. A mother's devotion to serve her child is a form of charity. That's why charity begins at home. Because the mother is doing what she's doing without any expectation. Charity must be given without any expectation. Charity must be only given with the hope that those who receive the gift of the charity will benefit tremendously. Thus, this is what is called the good quality. Then he goes on to give us the analogy of those who are good. He says the good will endure pain in the interest of others. They will endure pain so that others may get better, like someone who may go through a blood transfusion. They may go and give of themselves. They may feel pain. He gives us the analogy of two types of tree. He says one tree allows you to rip the bark of the trunk so that it can be made into material that will cover the human body. So it goes through pain to bring comfort to others. And he says there's another tree who will allow you to take the bark so that you can make it into rope that will be used to hang someone or to tie someone. Both are giving the same thing. One is for the betterment of others, one is for the detriment of others. So it is not the gift that is important, it's a thought behind the gift. As I'm known to say, it is not the gift of the lover that's important, it is the love of the giver. So both trees are giving their bark, one to bring comfort, one to bring pain. Prem sul Sitapati Ramachandra Bhagavan ki jai. He goes on, and I continued our katha tonight. To describe the qualities of the good and those who are not.
Sanaiva kalapara bandana karai kalakari vipati saimarai Sri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Rama Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Kalvino Swarat Para Apakari Shri Ram Jai
says those people of an impious nature, those people of an impious nature, what we say, the bad nature, he says they will do things to harm others for no reason. Not because you've done them something wrong or they will get some benefit from it, they will just do it because they will do it. You know, I remember once a long time ago, in the country that I came from where there were racial violence. And I remember as a little boy, running around without any thought in my mind that I could be putting my life in danger. And watching these street gangs in the city that I lived in, roaming the streets and destroying people's property at will. And then I stood there and heard, when they attacked someone's home and the man came outside with a gun in his hands and a cutlass and said, "You guys come here and I'm gonna kill you." He says, "We're only having fun." One of the gang members who were attacking and destroying, he said, "We're only having fun and you're trying to kill us." That is also, the Lord is saying, there are people of that nature. In their minds, to destroy your property or to hurt you is fun. It was a good day out on the street. And there are many, says people of this nature, who will do things to hinder you without gaining any value, just that they want to hinder you, or to offend you, or to hurt you. Prem Sabha Sitapati Ramachandra Bhagavan Ki Jai. And he says, Para Sampada Vinasi Nasai Jimi Sasi Hati Va Upala Vilai.
Ji Ram Jai Ram.
Ketu, you know, the Graha, Rahu, and then we have Ketu. It says when you are afflicted by Ketu, if we are told that this Ketu Graha is negative to you, then it leads to it is a source of calamity, all kinds of trials and tribulations in your life. And then you'll want to say, "What did I do to Ketu?" But Ketu's attachment to you reflects negativity. It says, these people of this nature, having destroyed their neighbor's property, they may do it and get no value, but never think to any moment that they are destroying someone else's value. Like the hail which melts away to nothing after ruining the crops. You know, when hail falls, it's beautiful, but it destroys all the young plants, and then it melts and becomes water. But they never thought that when I'm falling as hail, look what the destruction I'm doing. He says, there are human beings of that nature. And he said, that represents the not so good, or what's called the bad. He goes on to explain,
Santa Udaya संतत सुखकारी विश्व सुखद जिमि इंदु तमारी
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम श्री राम जय राम।
నిందాసం అగణ చరితా శ్రీరామ
On the other hand, those who have the good quality are like the sun and the moon, that when they come into play, they always, the sun's existence brings nutriment and energy to everything on the surface of the earth. The moon in its bright night presents beauty and adds gravity to the world, controlling us, and presents movement of the waters of the ocean. Everything is done for a positive intention. He says, so it should be the good quality. And I'm tempted to read again what was presented in our magazine for the thought of the month about the good. To live life without expectations from others. Work hard on all of your activities with good intentions. Seek nothing in return and be content with whatever you receive. These are some of the qualities of a happy person. A happy person is a good person. Happy, you know, some people do bad things, like the people, the gangs who said, we were just having fun, they're happy. That's not the kind of happiness I'm talking about. The happiness I'm talking about is when we are content in our mind. When we feel good about ourselves, and we bring no harm to others in so feeling. Prem su Sitapati Ramachandra Bhagavan ki jai. Then parama dharma ritu bhidit ahimsa. Ahimsa, ahimsa kya matlab hai? Ahimsa means non-violence. He said the highest religious merit there is to, what the Vedas declare, is to have, do no harm, whether by words, by action, or by thought. When we think of harm, we think of, I hit you, or I say something. But even my thoughts, I'm thinking of hurting you, that is also hurting. I mentioned sometimes that we all have thoughts about killing some people once in a while. Then we are not practicing ahimsa. Because remember, the words, the action are rooted in thought. You think of it, you then act upon it, then you will say it and then act upon it. So ahimsa means non-violence by words, thought or action. He says that is the highest religious merit, to live in the world in the state of ahimsa. And you know, it has been proven, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi lived on the principle of ahimsa. And he's been given the title of Mahatma, a man renowned in the world. This ahimsa concept of that, to live the highest religious merit. He is considered to be a divine entity. Jesus Christ speaks about loving thy enemy and thy neighbor. Hinduism preaches that, forgive those. The whole concept is non-injury. And this is considered to be, according to Ramcharitmanas, the highest religious merit. Now someone said, Panditji, you mean doing puja, doing prayers is not highest religious merit? It seems like highest religious merit is how we relate to other human beings. Highest religious merit is acquired through our relationship with other human beings. Now someone said, Panditji, why do we need to pray then? Because by prayer, we learn to acquire these qualities of being kind, understanding, forgiving, and not wanting to hurt, not wanting to hurt, and not wanting to hurt. Only through prayers, only through relationship to God, can we acquire this gentle and serene tendency. You know, it is said, when you see a beautiful carving of something, it looks so beautiful, and you said, that is what a carving should look like. But then, you don't get carvings just appear just like that. What happens? somebody puts it against a grinder, use a knife on it, sharpen it, drills it, burns it, polishes it. It has to go through the process before it becomes a beautiful carving. Before you and I can be carved into being a perfect human being, we have to go through the process of contemplation, through austerities in the name of God, and then the mind is molded towards this pure status. Prem Sita Pati Ramachandra Bhagavan Ki Jai.